So I'm going to present you how to build some Rudder plugins and what to do with them. So I'm Felix. I'm working at Rudder for 2 years now. You can find me on IRC or Gitter under the nickname FDAL. So let me know if you are interested in anything. Last year here at Config Management Camp, we released the 5.0 of Rudder and we presented the new Rudder plugin ecosystem. This year, I will try to explain to you how to build some, because we did not have that much of community contribution on the plugins. We had some, but not enough, and that's mostly our fault because it's not very well documented, and we did not try to. So currently, we have three types of plugins that we can find in Rudder. The classic one, which are often linked between the Rudder API and other tool API, like the monitoring tools. We have Centurion, Zabbix, and other one. The advanced feature plugins, that are the most old one and the most Rudder dev based one, because they are in Scala, so it's maybe more difficult to build. And we have the policy package ones, which are really new, where you had a small insight with CES before. So we are more and more trying to do policy plugins because we are lacking currently a pretty way to share our policies that we are designing through Rudder with other people, and so share our experiences and our configuration knowledge. Currently, starting from 6.0, we have the old OPT Rudder share commands Rudder / PKG, which has been renamed in just a Rudder command, which is Rudder package, which you can use very on an easier manner. And we will see briefly how it works. So it's keep a local database, which is JSON-based, to keep track of all the plugins that are currently installed on the system and all the files that they are installing to track them and not let file leak on the system when you are installing plugin within them. So it's quite like a classical package manager, but for Rudder plugins. So it's Python-based, you can check it on your server. And all the plugins at install time will have a dedicated location, which will be created on your server by the Rudder package CLI, which is under OPT Rudder Share Plugins. This is the place where you want to put all your scripts or everything that you are using in the script that is not some tool that is designed to be used by the end users. Like the PostRM or Pro PostInst script that you do not want to show to the user but want to be used by the plugin. This is what the Rudder PKG index that keep track of everything look like. Just for knowledge. So this is for reference. You do not have to read it here, except if you have some severe problem. So the plugin structure, that will be more interesting. So currently we are using RPKG file that is a Rudder for, it stands for Rudder package file. So it's an R archive because it is really easy to use and have some nice properties that you can check some file in it without deflating all the archives, so you can access the metadata, which is like the control file of your plugin pretty easily without having to deflate all files. And you will have different .txt archives, which will contain the real control file of the plugin and all the files that you will deploy on your server. That's what basic metadata should like. So you have, it's JSON based and you have some several key values that are pretty common, like type, it will always be plugin, the name of your plugin, the version. The version is important in Rudder plugins because the Rudder package CLI we'll check for compatibility. So you can restrain your plugin to be only compatible with some major version of Fedora or some minor. And you will do this using the version. You can do dependencies and stuff. The jar file are only used for the scalar based one base plugin. So we'll take a look at the control files that you can use to build your plugins. They are optional. If you just want to deploy some files and nothing and do nothing on them, you do not need them. But in most cases, you will need at least a post-inst, a pre-RM, to be able to do what you want on the server. So you have to put them in one of the specific archives. On the previous slide, it specifies that you need to have at least this archive and another one, which is for the content. So you need to dissociate the control files and the file content. Kind of like what Debian does for its deb file, deb package. So the versioning. I told you before, it's important because the Reader package CLI will be based on that for plugin compatibility and check for, is it compatible? Is it working on your Reader server or not? So how is it constructed? It's just the major version of Reader. It can be a minor like 5.1 or anything, and the version of your plugin. Very simple. That's the dependencies. You can add dependencies on your plugin. There is no plugin to plugin dependencies for now. Maybe in the future, we have already some case that could need it, but it will need quite a lot of work. So we are not supporting right now. Currently, the dependencies are only informative and will just do some display at install time, except for binary one, but it's not very good for dependencies. So you should maybe not base your packaging on it. The basic plugin will just be a metadata and two archive files that we saw. And there is two steps that are more critical, I think, that installs, which is the removal of the plugin and the upgrade. So removal, we will run the pre-RM if it exists, if you define it in the file archive that we saw before, and it will execute it. If it succeeds, it will then remove all the files that were tracked in the index.json that we saw before. And after that, it will remove all the control files that were used. An upgrade, we keep it simple. It's basically a remove and an upgrade and an install of the new version. So it's not so much, but it can be sufficient for most of our case. We unfortunately, we do not support yet some conf file notions that we can have in some package, in some packaging like Debian or anything else. So currently, you will have trouble if you are trying to deploy some conf file in your plugins at upgrade time, because it will be removed if you packaged it. So you have to find a way on it. So in general, that's for all plugins. If you are doing APA related stuff, you will want to use a Reader API client lab, which is based, it's automatically generated, and it's based on our documentation of the API, so it should be up to date every time. It's Python based, so if you are using anything at Python, than Python, it will be hard for you, but you can still manage it. So, but if you are doing Python, we really recommend you to use this, because if anything changes in the API, you will have nothing to change, but the dependency of other of the lib will change, but it is packaged, so I'm not sure if I'm very clear on it. So we package the API, the API lib, in like a traditional package. So it is available on all your servers, and it will be easily upgradable. And so, see the API change, you will not have to change all the code in your plugin. That's it. We will now talk about the policy plugins, which are the most strange one, because before in Rudder, it was super difficult to export some configuration from a Rudder server to another one. It is still difficult, but at least it is doable. So what we want to do, since Rudder is a graphical tool based, we want to be able to use the newly imported configuration policies as if we were creating them before via the Rudder API UI. So there should not be different from what the user can create on his own. That was the goal. So we will only check for NCF-based or Technique Editor-based techniques for the people that have already done Rudder, so you know what I mean. And that's the goal we want to achieve. So the first plugin to integrate this feature was CIS. Just a quick reminder on how Rudder works. So to make policies in Rudder, you will use some methods that will be used in techniques that you will define via the Technique Editor. You will use this technique, which are template of configuration, and deploy them in directives that will be applied to group of nodes using rules. It's quite complicated saying like that, but when you are using it every day, it's pretty simple. But what's important there is that you have dependencies between the different objects. And so if you want to deploy some new techniques in a plugin, you will have to have all the methods that need to be already on the server. So you will need to package methods. Methods are not easy to package. Currently, the best way for you to do so is to put them in the var Rudder configuration repository NCF30 generic methods folder. Honestly, not so much people are developing methods, except some people that have very specific use case. So it should not happen for everyone. For the techniques, if you do not need the method, it will be pretty easy. There is an API that you can use. The API is unfortunately not documented, but to do this presentation, I had to make the CIS plugin. I had to check what was sent on everything on the Technique Editor and check for the JSON answer and was and call. So you can use it. Pretty difficult, but it's doable. You can create categories when you are pushing the JSON to create the techniques via the API. And this way, you will have techniques from the Technique Editor that will be imported under a category and will not pollute all your already created techniques. And it will be much easier to organize in the UI. Hopefully, I wrote, and many people did before, a Rudder synchronized script that can import and export techniques, rules, and directives, and all the dependencies. So you will not need to check for the API or anything. You can just run the script, like export this rule, and it will export all the needed rule, directives, and techniques, and import it in the same manner. So I encourage you to try this. For the directive, yeah, that's what I said. It's pretty easy, but you can do it via using the tool before. There is still some cases that are difficult. which is the removal and upgrade case, because like I said before, we need to track every single file that are packaged in the plugin. But if you are creating objects using the API, they are not packaged. So at upgrade time or removal time, you will keep track. You will not be able to keep track of everything that happened on the server, and you will have unwanted leftovers. So you will have at creation time of the plugin to keep track of every UID of the object that you will be created at install time, which is quite hard. And you will need to remove them in the pre-RM of your plugin afterwards. This is bothersome, especially since when you are dealing with techniques, the people, since they are integrated perfectly in the UI, the people can modify them. They can create new directives from the newly imported techniques. And so there are also elements that you cannot keep track of that can be added. And you need to manage them because you cannot wipe out all the directives of the people just because you think that they did not create new one and push your new one from the new version of the plugin. It's still doable. I put something pretty early here, which is a one-liner to see whenever to get all the techniques created from a special generic method that you imported via a plugin. You can do exactly the same with the directives and the techniques. And you will need to, if you want to create a plugin like that. Unfortunately, we did not have a tool yet which does all of this. I hope I will be able to make one in the current month. So that's it. Thank you.